Gracious ones, I come this day to invest a cosmic energy field of blue fire lightning into, through, and around you as a son, a daughter of God. And this investment is a charge of cosmic dynamism. It is a charge of blue fire radiance. It is a charge to rise higher into your divine selfhood and fulfill your mission, your reason for being upon this earth. Many of you have dallied in this earth for quite some time, blessed ones. And if you truly desire to lift off of it into the realms of eternal light, then the will of God must be that charge that you accede to, that you attune to, that you allow to manifest through your will, your reason, and your heart fire. This will is exciting to embrace for those who are intrepid, for those who are daring, courageous, and brave in the spirit. This blue fire light will ennoble you in new and exciting ways to discover the all possibilities of God within you. Yes, blessed ones, when you embrace the will of God, when you are inspired by that blue fire radiance, nothing is impossible, and you too may accomplish that which I accomplished with the 12 labors, which, as you know, symbolize the conquering spirit that comes as the mastery of the 12 lines of the cosmic clock. Well, have you truly discovered your own clock within, blessed ones, whereby there is the ticking off of those assignments that you have self-given to your soul to accomplish during this life? Have you truly seen that which your own higher self desires for you to rise into in times of meditation, when you can access the allness of your true blue selfhood as you attune to the source and the first ray of the dawn in those early hours of the morn, when all is still, when all is fresh, and when there is that charge of light that comes from the sun and from your own God-Son presence to deliver you from everything less than the perfect self, who you truly already are in God. We have said these words again and again, and yet at times you embrace stasis. You embrace almost a sense of self-annihilation by not leaping into the arms of God and embracing that which the Spirit speaks unto your heart and soul as what is required in the moment, in the now of eternality, in your present life, circumstance, and experience. Blessed ones, I provide with Amazonia this new charge this day, so that as you move through the final hours of Capricorn, you may truly know that you have won over many, including the vibratory energies of your own self, to God for the highest purpose in this life, that you have mastered at the level that you can access it, the flame of God power, in order then to move into the field of God love with greater awareness, with greater self-knowledge and understanding, with greater virya to fulfill all that is essential to be accomplished this year, 2015. Why it is still fresh for you. And if you truly desire to be God taught and to be accepted into the higher vibratory energy fields of the initiates and adepts who are precipitating the golden crystal age of Aquarius now through their own consciousness and then fanning it out into the world consciously day by day through beautiful and harmonious works, givingnesses, and the talents vouchsafed to them from the Almighty, then, dearest ones, you will be happy. For happiness comes when you are in the driver's seat and charged with that blue fire radiance of Hercules in Amazonia, of Archangel Michael in Faith, of beloved El Morya, and many other blue fire masters of the light. Why do we deliver this charge this day and not some other? Because we see what is at stake, what is at hand, and what is on the horizon, blessed ones. And in some cases, for some of you, it is not and may not be to your liking. And therefore, the primary way that you can move through the opportunities and challenges that will be coming to you is by this divine joy of self-mastery that we bring. Yes, you may sing that other song that I love, if you choose during your services, for Dorothy Lee will not in any way be displeased. For you see, the joy of self-mastery is the joy of overcoming. The joy of self-mastery is the joy of God resonating within the vibratory field of your aura now with an intensity and a vibrancy and a power that is transcendent and allows you to soar to new heights of cosmic and even solar and galactic consciousness. Dearest ones, the way to overcome is by way of a heart, mind, and will trued to the eternal fire of God that is already resident with you as the magnificent threefold flame provided you as that spirit spark of your divine selfhood in the secret chamber of your heart. Have you truly embraced this fire? Have you felt it? Have you encouraged it to grow? Have you fanned it in some way each day through a new excitement about your life and that which God has placed within you as free will to experience the allness of God within nature, within the great footstool kingdom that is your world, this earth, in all of its glory, majesty, and harmony. If you can truly answer yes to this, then you are an initiate, and you are one of our own. And if you have not fully embraced the totality of who you are as a God, man, or woman, living a true, purposeful life, then I say, challenge yourself, dare yourself to just do it and to be it and to accept this new relationship with the Ascended Masters that will literally lift you out of your seat and into a new realm of divine beingness. Many of you spend a number of hours in your chairs, and I say, get off of those couches and seats and chairs. Move your body temple. Get outside and activate the new blue currents that El Morya has shared with you now for a number of years, that originate from the great central sun, if you would be stymied in yesterday's accomplishments, then I say, why are you even breathing the breath of life today? Accept the new challenges. Stretch the limits of your life energy field and feel that all things are possible unto you in God through the light of the Christ that empowers you to truly know divinity, love, and every virtue that you may choose to embrace. Dearest ones, often you settle for much less than heaven would give you if you would simply open your minds, attune your heart, and stretch forth your hands to receive the graces of God that are all around you and within you. Here is my key to alchemy. Demand the best of yourself, and then move something of the obstacles of what you perceive as before you out of your way by a directed laser focus of intention and then action that obliterates darkness and manifest the great eternal light of God right before you and in your aura. Yes, blessed ones, you can accept God and embrace God now if you choose. A new authentic life of beingness, holiness, and this will enrapture you into that which is sublime, magnificent, and worthy of you experiencing in your life. You see, those who embrace challenges are the true heroes and heroines of all ages. Those who embrace that which is before them as opportunity truly know that God is within that opportunity and that the light that they will drink in and have fired within them as they dare themselves to move beyond all limitation truly understand what God beingness is, what the authentic reality of heaven is, and what they, if they truly desire eternal freedom, may win through complete and total surrender to the highest of God's light in the now. We have said these words again and again and again, and yet, living in the 3D veils of the flesh, it seems that it requires another boost here and there to move you past the sense that you cannot, which is truly that you will not. Well, will yourself to do it. Will yourself to be it. Will yourself to accept God as the totality of who you are. Your true self vibrating with. This new energy field, this new blue light from Sirius. I am serious, and yet I am jovial. I am somewhat of a demanding master. And if you could see what I am encouraging even El Morya to stretch into and to become as an ascended master, you would be amazed, blessed ones. You see, he is still an initiate of the sacred fire. And as he comes to me often, and as we echo our sentiments between Half Dome and El Capitan, there is a dynamic in the relationship of Guru and Chela, of Master and Disciple, that allows for the magnificence of the cosmic embrace to be borne by the disciple of the Master, so that that one may be empowered to rise, rise, rise to new cosmic heights every moment of their divine life. You can live a divine life if you choose to accept it through the breath of the Holy Spirit, through true love of God and one another and of your higher self. You may choose to live this divine life now and not at some distant and future heaven experience that is beyond your conception or your embrace. Embrace it now. Give that prayer and song, Hercules embrace, and I will embrace you. I will empower you. I will lift you out of the dregs of consciousness unwed to God, so that you may truly know who you are and live this authentic and dynamic life of a spiritual adept. Some blessed ones cannot take the fire, and so they slink into the shadows, thinking that somehow this movement is only about some conception of mamby-pamby love and friendship, where all are embraced no matter what their vibratory field. While I say that we are primarily about creating initiates and adepts, and if those who choose to walk into the light that we empower within you do so, they will be transformed by the love who you are and the fire that you project through an aura supercharged by the Elohim. Does this mean that you are always intense? Of course not, blessed ones. Love, love, love is what empowers all in God to be fulfilled and to be joyful. And yet without that will and that divine experience of knowing God within your soul as a spiritual fire of your being, then how can you access more? How can you truly be freed from all of the preconceptions of that which you now know to be unreal of your lesser self? Burn through that which is unreal and untrue and a chimera that you have embraced around your core God identity. Burn through it now, O angels of the sacred fire, and release these, my disciples, into a new matrix of perfection, of divine joy, and holy radiation. Blaze forth the light of the great central sun here within the earth, and if it causes somewhere upon this planet an earthquake or a cataclysm, so be it. The earth must be ready for many new blue waves of fire, for all to be transformed into the Golden Crystal Age of Aquarius. The cataclysm that I speak of course, blessed ones, will not come upon those who embrace God and their lives. It is a transformational wake-up call, this cataclysm, that allows them to see clearly that what they had accepted is no longer acceptable, that what they had embraced as a life of violence and licentious living is no longer the way of today, that what they had decidedly accepted as a religion that somehow, in their own sense of darkness, embraces violence and killing, is now exposed as debauchery, evil, and a false theology. Blessed ones, the earth must come to terms with the realities of the higher realms, where there is only light, there is only love, there is only ongoing communion with the all in all. As God permeates everything, and as divine joy is ensconced in every particle of creation, we, the Elohim, are now about the recreation of this world through the co-creative efforts of our disciples and initiates, so that it may be transformed into heaven upon earth. Think of how you may work decidedly and perceptibly to somehow each day bring heaven to earth through your conscious attitude and a forthright spirit of being a co-creator with us, dearest ones. If at the end of each day you can truly say to God, I gave my best, I did my all today, O my Lord, for you, in bringing something of your kingdom into play here upon earth, then, dearest ones, the smile of the Elohim will be upon you, and you will be lifted swiftly to our retreats and other retreats of the great ascended masters to receive your next assignment, your education, your charge of light. We honor those in the earth who sacrifice all, who give all, on the altar of the heart. And even if they give to a cause which later, from a higher vantage point, may be seen as not quite in alignment with the holy will of God at the most supernal level, yet their sacrifice, their all-givingness, will be noted as an acceptable offering and will move them into the new dynamics of higher virtuous lives, where the ultimate ascension may be experienced, where they are unified with the Creator, the Divine Light, in that complete experience of surrender and givingness to the One. If you have made your peace with God by making your pact with God to fulfill the will of God in your life, then I claim you as my own. I initiate you again and again, and you will experience miraculous joys, divine excitement, as you live, move, and have your being on the playing field of the Lord. Yes, we are decidedly about God's business. And we sell our wares only to those who give. The coin of the realm that comes from their hearts. Those who are rebirthing from within themselves by God's grace and through love into the new era. I am Hercules. And if you dare to come to Yosemite sometime during this life, and you pray on your knees, I will be there to accept your prayer, your request, and empower you toward your godhood. And miracles will ensue, and your new life will begin. Thank you, Blessed Hearts, for what you have surrendered and given. For in that experience, God provides. And in that provision, Providence shines upon you, and you are free. I thank you.